Hey, so I'm here stretching the best. And first thing I like to do is just get the body to relax. So sometimes by shaking the body up, it can be a very relaxing thing to do, particularly after a tough workout. So I just want to note that I'm not on the spine, I'm just off the spine. Actually, some spine's here, and the heels of my hands are right off the end of it, and then I'm rolling, pushing away from the spine. Yes, in our society, we tend to be very tight in the hips. Particularly in this whole connection between the hip and the trunk. So I like to just get some motion in there. So even though we're focusing on stretching Deborah's upper body today, definitely taking care of that link between the trunk and the lower body is always a key thing to do. You may notice the position of my hands. When you think about the direction of the ribs, everybody thinks the ribs go this way, but it's really more of a slightly upward motion. They swoop and go upward. So if you push in that direction, it tends to be very relaxed into the climb. That's what it really opens up. It's going to bring her arms across the back of her body, bring it into horizontal abduction. And this can be considered a really nice chest opener. So let's get right under the shoulder. And then make sure that I'm by the head of the humerus. I'm just opening her up here. The other thing I want to keep in mind is that I'm applying a little bit of traction, just a gentle amount. And that can really create some more motion in the shoulder joint. Which in our society of tight shoulders, it's a really nice thing to do. These stretches can happen in a variety of ways. But it's a key to make sure that the shoulder doesn't elevate. So I'm abducting your shoulder, but I'm also helping it glide downward. And you're not going to get the same amount of range of motion here, but you're still going to get a bit of a stretch. How does that feel, Deborah? She says it feels great. So I also want to go into my form here. So you'll see that my left elbow is very close to my body, and with my right arm, even though my arm is aloft, you know, it's out in front of me, I'm definitely stabilizing from my shoulder blades. The reason for that is that I don't want to overuse my arms, because sometimes as trainers we have to do this 7, 8, 9, maybe 10 times a day. So you have to be able to maintain a strength to do certain work. And that means the more you generate force or stability from your trunk, the less effort it's going to be for your practitioner to work on your cardio. The other effect is that you're also going to notice that when you generate force from your trunk, you're not just pushing. It's going to feel a lot less invasive to the client. It should feel more like an integration. It should flow into your client, not work against it. Personal training is a relationship, so you've got to maintain that and let the client feel that we're working together at all times. So at this point, I'm working on stretching the bicep. So some clients, you have to be careful. Because you want to make sure that you don't get the head of the humerus to roll forward, because then that can move the shoulder out of the joint. And what we're trying to do is get the shoulder to move well inside of the joint. So at this point, I'm feeling that the head of the humerus, which you can't see from here, maybe we'll come around and take a look at that. So the head of the humerus is here, and it, you know, comes around. But at this point, I'm starting to feel it against my fingers. So that's about as far as I need to take it. It's very common. I'm going to do this wrong, spit out. Of course, it's still super crunch because it's very flexible. But really, it's going to get more. If I bring it here, right to the point before it moves into my finger, and then add some traction. How does that feel, Deborah?
I feel
the stretch. So, now we're stretching the muscle without stressing the joint. Another time what tends to happen is when we do what I call the bra strap stretch. I call it that because, you know, men typically never have a reason to do this, but women go behind and they undo their bra strap. So, what I try to do here is, once again, still keep in mind the location of the head of the humerus. So right now, it doesn't feel like it's moving out of place. So we're just going to bring it up and around. And if I feel the pressure, which I do now, I just try to adjust it accordingly so we keep it nice and safe inside of the glenoid humeral joint. And then we end up stretching the shoulders, the upper trapezius. You probably feel it up here, correct?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Now we're going to come around and stretch the triceps. So the key thing to keep in mind here is that, like I was talking about earlier, when the arm rolls one way, it's supposed to glide, the shoulder blade should glide in the opposite direction. That's what healthy shoulder movement is about. So right now we've rolled her shoulder up, so we need to make sure the shoulder blade is gliding downward. And it has. You can feel a relaxation in Deborah's upper trapezius, so we know there's no tension there, there's no elevation of the scapula. And then that's how we know we can get a really nice stretch in our triceps. If you know where my fingers are, I'm just keeping my fingers here to keep the shoulder blade depressed. I don't really need to with Deborah, she's pretty relaxed. Yeah, she's got great shoulder mobility and stability. But that's not always the case for all of my clients. So it's just a good thing to keep in mind. Once again, I want to talk about my form. As you can see, my chest is prominent, my elbows are close to my body, and I'm leaning into the table. So that's what's going to give Deborah the most feeling of support, and also give her a good stretch. I'm going to do the same on the other side. So we started off with some... Well, actually, we started off with some jostling. So, jostling is kind of more about massage sort of move. But we'll say that this is not crossing the line of, you know, going beyond scope of practice people who are just trainers. So remember, the ribs are at an angle. They're not straight across. They're at an angle. So by really working with the direction of the ribs flow, it's going to feel much more natural, much more comfortable, much more smooth to the client. The more comfortable the client feels, the easier they can relax. And of course, the better stretch you can give them, which means the better side they feel, which means to change. So Deborah's had a little bit of an adjustment that occurred here. Incidental, not what I was aiming for, but it's not a bad thing. So your client is going to think, oh, that's cool. And you'll say, all right, that is cool. Typically, snap, crackles, and pops are just synovial fluid being released into the joint, which is a very good thing. So remember that the chest, pec major, has two sets of fibers. You have clavicular fibers, and you have sternal fibers. So when I'm bringing the arm up a little bit higher, you're going more into the sternal fibers, which have more of an angular sort of fiber direction. And when we go straight across, which is what I was doing before, it's more on the clavicular fibers. So You may note that when I move around, everything's always coming from pretty much the entire body. It's more of a dance. And as weird as that may seem, clients really feel that. It's much more natural feeling for them. More importantly, for us, the trainers, it's going to be just much easier in our bodies. I'm going to keep re-stressing that because it's very critical. A lot of trainers may shy away from stretching because they get tired or they get worried about overdoing it and hurting the client. Is that okay, Debbie?
Good.
So once again, I'm stabilizing the head of my humerus here. Right? So here's the acromion. Here's the clavicle. Here's the acromion and here's the clavicle, and then the head of the humerus is right here. So I'm stabilizing that. That's what we want to keep the most safe. All these other structures, they're going to be pretty stable. And then we're doing that bra strap step again. And this is great because it's so stable here, I can only feel the muscle stretching. And I bet Debra feels the same.
Yes.
I'm stabilizing what's in for my trunk, but it's not too much work for my arms. I'm not overly concerned with gripping with my hands. I'm more concerned with stabilizing from the trunk. So very much like a workout that I just put Debra through, if you can follow those key features, you'll see that you'll have a lot more energy to do whatever movement you need to perform. In exercise or in stretching. I'm just a little tired here. So what we're gonna do is just come down. So we know that the fiber direction of upper trapezius starts at the base of the skull and it comes down to the acromion process. So I'm just gonna do is just put some gentle pull here. A very easy stretch. There's some cool neck stretches that we might do in a moment, but since I just want to really get that tricep stretch in before I turn her over, I just want to try to relax in here a bit. So, I am a massage therapist, but I'm trying not to show any massage techniques because that's going to be beyond the training scope of practice. So, I'm just going to keep it very simple and see if we can create a little more length in the neck. That feels a little more relaxed. You probably even see that. It looks like dough. And Deb is very built. So, but a healthy muscle should feel like dough or relaxed, and only tense when it's contracted, and when you want it to contract. So we have a little more movement here. There's still some tension here, but not so much that we can't get a good tricep stretch. And it just tells me that I need to stretch her neck out when we turn over. Okay, let me turn you over. Turn you back. I think she's looking pretty relaxed.
Yeah.
So this is one of my favorite stretches to do. So you always want to remember proper shoulder alignment. When people tend to do a shoulder stretch, they tend to do this. Their shoulder's way up here and they're pushing it even more out of alignment. So what's happening is the head of the humerus is now banging into the acromial clavicular joint and you're getting friction. So not only are you not getting the best stretch that you can get, you're also creating friction in the AC joint and also the glenohumeral joint. So not a good thing to do. What we want to do is we want to maintain that roll and glide that I was talking about a little bit earlier. So you want to keep the AC joint low, so that and also you may notice that even though it looks like I'm completely in the AC joint, I'm sneaking my thumb here around the head of the humerus and then just leaning down. So this is a bit of a tricky stretch because there's a lot more happening than that. As I'm bringing it across, I'm also bringing the shoulder down towards the table. So I'm pushing down this way and I'm shifting it over this way. I'm rolling the shoulder in one direction and I'm gliding it in the other direction. And that probably feels tremendous. By the way, this also has the added effect of stretching out the upper trapezius. The upper trapezius. That's a nice all-in-one stretch. And being that that's something that I made up on my own, I feel more inclined to teach that to trainers and massage therapists. So we're just checking the external and internal rotation. So you can see Dub has a little bit of restriction here in internal rotation. So what we can do about that is we can stabilize the joint. Alright, so now I'm just leaning in. Once again, using my entire body, not tiring my arms out. And no, it doesn't seem like it's a big deal because, you know, I'm bigger than Deborah is. You force yourself to work like that all day long, it gets very tiring. You could be 250, 6'4". You'll get tired. So it's all about really making sure you use your body weight to do the movement. Is that pressure okay, Deborah? But not invasive, correct? So one of the best ways to maintain good body mechanics, think about your head as if it's going towards the ceiling, and it's going to be right on top of your shoulders. Shoulder blades are retracted, chest is prominent, and you don't want to tense up, this is going to sound weird, you don't want to tense up your pelvic floor. So you're going to feel a lot of relaxation in the hips. I mean, in all the way through the hips, not just the outside of the hips, in between the hips, everywhere. And you also want to make sure that your heels are grounded. So you're not on your toes, because that's going to create unnecessary tension in your hips to make up for the lack of stability on the ground. So let's take another look at that. There's still a little bit of tension here, but I feel like there's a little less than before. So, I'm going to come around and just stretch Deborah's pecs a bit more. But I think we did a pretty good job while she was prone. So you can see, there's a lot of give. So this is a very healthy muscle tissue here. You may also note, as I'm bringing it up, that shoulder, the upper trapezius, stays nice and low. I don't even have to do anything here. I'm just bringing it around, and everything is fine. So now we're just going right into a lat stretch. So I'm actually going to move Deborah up a bit. I'm not throwing her off the table. It's Tuesday after all. So it is stretch, she should feel straight down her side. She may even feel a little bit of tricep in this. And then if you want to take it further, not every client can take this. You can add a little bit of rotation. You may note on my body's position as well, once again, my torso is very tall, my heels are very much connected to the ground, and I'm just leaning back. I'm not using any muscle strength, I'm leaning back. What is happening is, once again, I am stabilizing my shoulder blades. Oh, that's always an active motion to make sure that I protect my own shoulders. Now I'll do the same thing on the opposite side. Once again, a lot of relaxation. You know, no tension in the pecs, no tension in the biceps. This is great. I may have to actually use someone else another time, just so I can find more things to work on. Typically, a lot of clients throw a lot of tension in their forearms and their biceps. So, what I would say, though, in those cases, is that there are some stretches that help with that, but not a lot of great ones. I would recommend using a foam roller, very gently, mind you, across the forearms, and maybe even across the biceps. Or just recommend them to your friendly massage therapist. And then a massage therapist can do very detailed work on your forearms and biceps to create more movement in your shoulders. Because if there's too much tension in the forearm and the bicep, it becomes very hard for the client to stabilize the shoulder joint from the trapezius muscles, serratus muscles, and all the other shoulder stabilizers. Yeah.
And that can make it very hard for you, the trainer, to get the best workout out of your client.
So, some gentle neck stretches. Always like just adding a little bit of a gentle, almost like a milk motion. And if you notice how I'm using my entire body, then I just hold and lean. And it feels like they're getting taller. And they love it. Head to one side, push away. You're now stretching the upper trapezius on the right side. So it's very important to use your body weight to do this, and not to force the issue, because you're working with someone's neck, very sensitive area. I don't think I have to go into so much explanation for that. You just want to feel very gentle and supportive. Notice how I move the neck very gradually, gently. You're going to show a lot of care. Okay, once again, personal training is about relationships, which means it's about trust. And the more your client trusts you, not only the better you can stretch them, the better you can train them in every way. See that? I just rest her head gently in my hands. I stabilize it so that she can feel safe. I place my hand on the opposite side and I just lean. Because I'm already cradling her hand here, so once I lean, it automatically creates a stretch. Gently roll it over, stabilizing it in my hand, and then just pushing away. If you want to get a little more bang for your buck, you can also lift the head slightly. Notice how, once again, I'm using my legs to do that. If you want to lower the head, just go down. If you want to lift the head, stand up. And just shift my body over. Come around. Place one hand here, cross the other hand, place it here, get to a small squat position, and I'm coming up from the body, once again. Everything comes from the entire body, working as one powerful unit. In this case, one powerful but gentle unit. Bring it around. Stabilize the base of the neck, base of the skull. Do it with the other hand. Place your face down. Thank you very much. How'd you feel?
I feel great. Stretched out and taller.
Alright, thank you very much. I'll see you next session.
Okay.